Hi, my name is Dan. In this video, we're going to be using Illustrator to build UI and web graphics. Okay, there's lots of free stuff here on my channel. Please subscribe, hit the little bell next to the subscribe button to get notifications. If you want more, loads more. Okay, check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description. In this video, we're going to talk about adding color to your site. We're going to start using something called Adobe Color CC. Okay, it used to be called Cooler if you remember him, but if you go to color.adobe.com and you sign in with your Creative Cloud license, okay, you'll get to here. If you have a pirated version, this is not going to work as well. Bits of it will work, okay? But we hope you got a legit version. What we're going to do is skip create and go to one called explore. And what this is really for is for people that, even experienced designers, like I find myself leaning on the same colors every time I do a design, okay? If you come to me and you're a baker and you need a website, it's probably going to be green and gray at the moment. And if you are, I don't know, some international airline and you need work done, I'm probably going to make it green and gray. I'm stuck in a trap of using green and gray. To escape my trap, I use this explore feature in Adobe Color. And what it means is I can go in here and under it explore, I think by default it's on, I'm not too sure, but go to most popular, I like it, of all time. Okay, maybe this month. And it's just gonna give you, yeah, the things that other people are downloading. Okay, the most popular colors. And often, really cool stuff comes to the top. Let's go of all time. And these ones here, yeah, loads of colors. Okay, and what happens is because you've logged in, what you can do is say that you like Tech Office. Okay, you can click on the one that says save. It's gonna say, you can rename it if you like. You can say, actually, I'd like you to put it into my, remember we made that library a little earlier called Dan's Portfolio? You can make a new one here, go right to the bottom, create new library, or just jam it into your, where is it? My library. Okay, but I'm gonna put mine into Dan's Portfolio. You could change it, okay, that's okay, but I'm gonna click save. And the cool thing about it is magically, hopefully, if I go to Illustrator now and Dan's Portfolio, sometimes you need to click that. Okay, and I'm gonna make this a little smaller. There he is there, those are the colors and I can start using them. Okay, I can decide that actually I'm gonna use that for the color. Okay, and it's just a good way to kind of start drawing things and you're like, okay, now things are starting to work in terms of harmony of color, okay, because I've started with this kind of templated color, I guess. Okay, it's a good way to get going with your colors. What you can do for this class is you can go to the exact same site, okay, and go to explore and go to search and type in BYOL, okay, and hopefully you'll find some of the ones that I'm using. The one I'm using in this class is called BYOL Portfolio Illustrator, okay, and download that one and we'll use that for this course. If you are working at, a larger agency, it's a great way to share brand colors. You can upload them. There's a couple of different ways. You can go to create, and you can go down here and say, actually, so CMYK, you can start typing these in and change them, okay? And then hit save, and they end up on this explore thing, okay? And people can search and share, and it makes it really easy, to share brand colors. So let's download the Bring Your Own Laptop one. Kind of forgot that check. BYOL, and then click on save, put it into Dan's portfolio. Great. Nice. Jump back into Illustrator. Click the little, that Creative Cloud icon, and there he is there. I'm gonna click on this guy, right click him and say, delete, don't need you. Cool, great, so we've got our colors in. Let's move on now and look at, let's say, because this is gonna be a brand for this particular fake company or fake portfolio we're doing. If you've got actually specific colors and a logo to work from, I'm gonna show you how to do that in the next video and pull those colors through. How good was that, right? If you want more, go check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description.